Okay, so this is going to be the rescue of a casualty who is in descent mode, so they're hanging in their descender, and I'm going to do it from a separate set of ropes. So I'm going to climb up from below, change into my descender, and I'm going to rescue the dummy down to the ground. So I'll head up first. Now I want to be sitting at basically the same height the casualty is in my descender. I'm going to lose a bit of height when I do a changeover, so I'm going to go up a little bit higher. Change into my descender. And definitely make sure you've got both descenders off the rope, because the last thing you want to be doing is in your descenders with the casualty hanging off. So if you'd come down from above to do this rescue, you'd already be in this position. So I'm going to get 2 points of contact between the two of us. So one of those points is going to be a cow's tail between the two of us, and that can be either one of my cow's tails or one of the casualty's cow's tails. So I'm going to take the casualty's cow's tail here, and I'm going to clip that into the D-ring on my harness, into my waist, so it's a connection from waist to waist. I'll drop down a little bit, touch high, so I'm basically at the same height as the casualty. Now the second connection, I'm going to use two carabiners chained together here, and one of those is going to go onto the casualty's chest D-ring. Now the advantage to going into the chest, if we go into his waist, it'll be safe enough, but he's going to be in this kind of upside down, bent over position, and if you've got an unconscious casualty, it's not a good position for them to be hanging. Now I've tried to keep this nice and neat. I've got both casualties ropes over that side. I've got my working rope on the right, my backup rope on the left, and I'm going to put a connection from the casualty's chest, and I'm going to go into the carabiner on my descender, so the side that's facing the casualty. So into here, check all the gates are screwed up, and now we can think about getting rid of the casualty's equipment. So I could take the backup off. If this was a duck, I would definitely take it off. If it's an ASAP, you could take it off, or I could just check that it isn't locked, but you definitely want to check it's not locked. I'm now going to abseil off the dummy on his equipment. So I'm going to lower him off, just treating it like it's your own. So one hand on the control rope, one hand on the handle, and just nice and gently lower down. The weight's then going to come onto the two carabiner connection. So I'm going to keep going all the way down. Good place to use the little yellow button here until it goes slack, and I can take the rope right out. So you can see the casualty's in a better position now than if he was hanging off his waist. Now this is not that comfortable position for me. I've got the dummy pushing in the front of my legs. It's starting to cut off the circulation. So again, trying to make sure the ropes are all out of the way. I'm going to chuck a leg over at that point, so I'm straddling the casualty. And then I need to think about coming down. So the safe working load of your descender in general is one person. So we can do a two-person rescue using it, but we need to do things a little bit differently. So I'm going to get a spare carabiner, and I'm going to connect that over the control rope that you normally hang on to, and I'm going to connect that to the carabiner on your descender. So this one is going to be on the side that's nearest to you. If you hold the rope down the way, it's not doing anything. So you need to hold the rope up. That generates a bit of extra friction. I'm then going to double check that both backups are unlocked, and then nice and steady, down we go. Now I'm going to get down to the ground. You could go all the way down so the weight comes off the connection between the two of you, or I could open that carabiner up, escape the system, but you would then lower the casualty off all the way onto the ground as soon as possible, because you don't want that casualty hanging in their harness for any longer than need be. If they're unconscious, you would now put them in the recovery position. If they're conscious, well, you would sit them in whatever position is most comfortable, just making sure their weight's off their harness.